there, as you said, not a lot to say. There wasn't much fight to judge in there. But overall, I mean, how did you feel about your performance? And obviously, everybody was incredibly impressed with what you did.
I felt great. I just need, you know, experience. This whole training camp went well, no injuries, no nothing. So I felt so good coming into the fight, especially being with Antonio. Everything just felt right. I mean, I was nervous. Of course, I'm always nervous, but I just knew this was just my time. I feel good at featherweight. 145 is the perfect weight. Strong, fast, and like I said, just need time. It's like time is my friend right now. So each time I keep fighting, it just gets better and better. So I'm having a good time.
The body shot was how you ended the fight, but it was there early for you as well. Did you have a feeling that was going to be a weapon you could use tonight?
I knew I was going to knock him out with the body shot. I didn't really say it. I just knew he was just long, lanky. I just knew if I got to the inside, I'd seen a couple of takes on him. He's taking some kicks to the body, which he didn't really like. So I knew if I get to the inside on him, I let it rip, he's just going to go down. There would be no way he would be able to stand. So I showed it tonight.
You know, as you're developing, I think people, they say, you know, your aggression is something to watch, but it's also a little concerning too. Maybe you're a little wild, maybe you're a little too fast out of the gate. What do you think? Do you think that's something you have to be careful about, or do you feel like that's actually a strength of yours?
I'm working on it with Antonio, my defense, but I'm a fighter. That's just what I do. Like I said, I'll take one to give five. That's just kind of who I am. And like I said, this is a fighting sport, and that's just, you're going to take punches. If I take 8 years off my life because I took some punches in the cage, I'm okay with that. As long as my family's good and I had a good career, we're fine with it. But like you said, I need to work on my defense. That's something I work on every day. And I'm a fighter. I'm just going there and fighting.
Nice. And last thing for me, I mean, obviously you've had these high expectations on you for so long, and you're still so young in your career, but where do you feel like you need to go from here? I mean, they're talking about championship fights and contender fights. Is that silly, three fights in your career, or do you feel like, you know, you're already at that level?
It's all up to my coaches, to be honest with you. I mean, my job right now is just focused on getting better. I wake up every day and I got to work on being the best fighter that I could possibly be. At the end of the day, I got to sit down with my team and figure out where to go next. I know, you know, being champ of the world, you know, just, of course I'm going to be there for sure, but it requires so much. You know, you got to, you know, take tougher and tougher fights. I'm only 21 years old. A lot of stuff going on. So when my team feels that I'm ready to fight for the championship, then I'll be more than happy to. But for me, mentally, I'm always ready to fight. That's just who I am. So.
Aaron, right here in front.
Yeah.
First, congratulations, man. When you landed that shot, did you know it was over before he went down?
Yeah, I knew he was out, or it hurt him pretty bad, but I just wanted to just seal the deal, make it, and the ref pulled me off, and I'm like, okay, then it's over with. But I just felt it. It landed flush on the stomach, and I knew there would be no coming back. I knew I was going to eventually stop him.
The body work in there was kind of maybe underutilized compared to obviously like boxing, but you know, is that something you're working on training, both kind of the effort to the limit?
I've always, ever since I started boxing, I had a natural feel for the left hook to the body. So I used to always hit it in practice. All my fights, that was something that I was very effective. So I just kept doing it. That's like my thing.
What's up, buddy?
Oh, gosh.
You had a great fight tonight, man. Amazing. How is it going with he and his camp coming through? Not just this, the fact that it's not just this fight, but moving forward, is there anything you have talked about on the games and his new debate in camp?
Yeah, first of all, Antonio, I mean, it goes just beyond training. I mean, I think he's the best coach in MMA. I mean, he works. I'm with him 6 days a week, twice a day, working. But it's just like mentally, he keeps me so relaxed and focused, which I'm very thankful for. It's just like, I can't really explain it. He's a great mentor for me, talks to me, training. It's just a good world. We clicked very, very well.
Have you guys talked about what's potentially next for you, or the opponents you guys might be interested in fighting?
No, we haven't really talked about that, but we've already talked about what we got thinking to do to get better. As we were waiting for this, we were talking about strategies for the future as far as getting better, working on lateral movement, certain things that we need to continue to grow as fighters. So,
what else? Just besides lateral movement, what else? Tell us, give us all the good details.
Nah, I can't. I can't. I'll save it for my next fight.
Good job tonight, guys. Clear.
Right.
I'm sorry, say that again?
Can you compare the knockout punches, Justin Lin versus this one?
For me, they're both really, really great, but I like this because I'm in front of my home, in front of my friends and family. The Justin Lin knockout was really good. I don't know, it's just anytime you get a knockout, it's just a good feeling.
And then I noticed you were ringside for Joe Diggs this time.
Yeah.
What was that like watching that spinning kick knocked out? Did it inspire you, motivate you?
He lands that in practice on me, and I know I feel for the guy because I think he's dead. So I'm happy it wasn't on me. It was on, and he's using it in the fight because every time I go with him, I'm always like something that he throws all the time, and if it lands, it helps me. Because he's landed on me plenty of times, so when he and Butler went down, I'm like, I feel for you because I think he's dead, because like I said, I've taken it before twice.
Can you explain a little bit, my last question, what you guys have going on there at the body shop, yourself, AJ McKee, Joey Davis, Hunter, and Joey McKee?
Yeah, I think we just all have different styles, we all have different personalities, but at the end of the day, it all fits well, just molds well. And we have a great leader, that's what I'm telling you. He structures practice the way we need to. That's his life, is making us the best fighters in the world. And just show up and come with your work boots on, give everything you possibly have. Antonio's there for you. We have a great group of guys that all have different styles, all have personalities, like I said. At the end of the day, we all hold each other accountable that we're going to be there at practice. And we show up to work, and we have something very, very special going on.
Hey, right here. That's three fights for you in 7 months. I'm curious, would you prefer to make another quick turnaround, or would you like some time off for the next fight?
I hope I fight soon. I mean, I'm healthy, and like I said, time is my friend. I need as much time as I can in the cage. This is what I love to do. I'm healthy. I make good money. I mean, what else can I ask for? I've got a good life, so I want to keep fighting. I'm very thankful. This is my job, and I love, sincerely love my job. So anytime I can get back in the cage, I'm for it.
7 months ago, you learned a pretty tough lesson in your fight, and since then, with two straight knockouts, it's been pretty impressive. What did you looking back on it, what's the biggest thing you learned in that fight that has turned out and has helped you in the next race of 2 months?
Yeah, for me, I mean, one is just the weight. I was up in weight. I won 55, and there's so many things that you can possibly say, but I just think the biggest thing is just, you know, it's just not relaxing. I just needed to take my time. But everything happens for a reason. There's so much positives came out of that loss that I'm actually very thankful for the loss. Like, I'm super, super thankful about a loss, man. Since you're guard, I think it sounds kind of funny to say, but if I wouldn't have lost, I wouldn't have been with Antonio, I wouldn't have been at a body shop. I probably wouldn't be training with Freddie Roach, and just so many things lined up for me that I'm super thankful for the loss and the rest of the world. But I'm right on track.
Last question for Josh.
Your body shop relationship, how are you balancing Antonio McKee as a trainer versus a father? Because his kids in the gym, same weight class. You guys have an agreement that will or won't fight each other? What's the dynamic there?
No. We've already talked about it. AJ and I won't fight. That's just a given. I mean, AJ McKee and I have been friends since we were little kids. We used to be at my house all the time, spending the night at local barbecues, on family trips with us. So, no, that's just weird. There's many people in the world to beat up rather than us fighting. It's just not going to happen. So,
AJ has designs on winning the title. He wants to be champion. Obviously, you do too. If you have that belt, you can stay at 45, or you can go back to 55.
There's things that we've talked about and discussed, but I can't say it now. But bottom line is that we're not going to fight. But we've had that discussion. We're not going to happen.
Yeah.
Okay, so your regular training partners, what does he bring you? What's the best thing that AJ does for you?
Everything. I mean, he's a problem. He's funky on the feet, throws all these kicks on the ground, he can submit you. I mean, it's just two different styles. What I have, the boxing, the wrestling, him is just the overall MMA, the flying kicks, the spinning elbows, it's just great. I haven't seen that. I've been wrestling for the past couple of years, just nonstop. So, perfect training partners for each other.
Congratulations, Sarah, on a great performance tonight. You made a tremendous, I would call it a perfect punch to the liver. And as we know, when you land there, it's over.
Yeah.
They're talking about the body shots. It's a fantastic group of you there. And it feels like there's a paradigm shift and a new group coming up together. On that subject of you and AJ and Joey Davis, could you predict for us at some point, without putting the words in your mouth, that perhaps the three of you, maybe at one time, may be the featherweight, lightweight, and welterweight champions?
100%. I think that's very well possible in the future. If we all, stick to what we do, train and be smart about our training and follow directions, yeah, we definitely all can be champs of the world.
So I cheated the answer out of you there, that AJ will probably fight a lot of you.
I don't know. We'll see.
But you'll never fight each other, will you? But there does seem to be a special group emerging.
Yes, yeah, for sure. I mean, like I said, we all have different personalities. We all keep each other accountable. I mean, I've known them since I was 4 or 5 years old wrestling. You know, we've been at the same kids program, so I just feel right at home.